There's nowhere quite like the jungle, from long-lost ancient relics to truly bizarre flora and fauna. You never know what you may find hidden amongst the trees and vines. These are the 20 strangest things found in the jungle. Number 20. Long-lost Mayan City. In recent years, it's come to light that the ancient Mayans were extremely adept as astronomers. They used the night sky to navigate and create their calendar, and it would seem that perhaps they were also using the stars to assist in their architecture and city design. A 15-year-old boy named William Godori, who hails from Quebec, Canada, has come up with a theory that involves the Mayans' astronomical abilities.
Found that the Maya put our city at different place to imitate the form of the constellation.
He suggests that the ancient civilization used the constellations to build their cities, and that this theory is apparently not as spaced out as it may sound. William used images from Google Earth, from the Canadian Space Agency, and maps of Mayan settlements in order to prove his ideas. Through his clever technique, he has also discovered the possible location of another previously undiscovered ancient Mayan city that's buried deep within the jungles of the Yucatan in Mexico. The trouble is that it's tricky to prove on the ground. Nobody has been there to try and prove his theory yet, and the whole area is completely covered in dense vegetation. It's also but impossible to see much of anything from inside the jungle itself. However, satellite imagery of the area does show the possible existence of a complex of pyramid shapes that are hidden beneath the tree canopy, and there are also parts of the image that could indicate a network of streets that are hidden below the overgrown jungle. Now, whether or not this discovery ends up being fruitful is still unknown. Only time will tell, I suppose. But if there's any truth to the theory, then the stars may lead archaeologists to many more previously hidden ancient discoveries. Before we go on, like this video, smash the subscribe button, and click the notification bell right now, or this centipede will crawl on your face when you're sleeping. Now it's time for the sweet topic. For this topic, I thought I'd take a little break from exploring the jungle to go to a very specific type of jungle that's closer to home, the common backyard. This farmer discovered a huge object in his backyard and is surprised by what it is. While digging on the land that had been in his family for generations, he would unearth this long-lost and hugely peculiar statue. For the many decades that the farm had belonged to him and his ancestors, none of them had ever thought to dig below the surface, but in finally doing so, he stumbled upon something truly peculiar and unexpected. It was probably some kind of religious statue, or something to do with the nearby church. And the crazy thing is, stuff like this is found far more often than you may think. There's an awful lot of buried history under our feet, just waiting to be discovered. And who knows, perhaps there's a fascinating piece of history under your home. As always, you can let me know your thoughts in the comments section down below by using the hashtag #SweetTopic. Number 19. The largest flower in the world. The plant that produces the largest individual flower on the whole of planet Earth is called the giant Padma, but it also goes by a gross-sounding pseudonym, the corpse flower. It turns out that this is because this particular flower is extremely smelly. Well, worse than smelly, it actually stinks like a rotting corpse. How lovely! Although disgusting, this is actually a clever adaptation that is shared by several flowers of its sort. The stink attracts plenty of flies, and these insects will help to pollinate the flowers, and then they ensure that they can reproduce. It is gross, but it's also extremely effective. So much so, in fact, that these flowers are the largest in the world, and they measure up to about 3.3 feet in diameter, weighing anywhere as much as 24 pounds. Number 18. The Boiling River. Lots of strange stuff seems to be going on out there in the depths of the Amazon region, but this is one of an especially bizarre and actually totally unique oddity. The Shane Timpishka, which is also known as La Bamba, is actually a small tributary of the mighty Amazon River. It's special when compared to others of its ilk on the account of its specific temperature. This is a so-called boiling river, the only boiling river in the whole wide world, apparently. The Shenandoah flows about 4 miles in length and is generally found to have a temperature that ranges between 113 degrees Fahrenheit and 212 degrees Fahrenheit. That's between 45 and 100 degrees Celsius for people who use proper measurements. The source of the river's heat is geothermal, which means that it's heated from within the earth, although its name would mean that boiled by the heat of the sun. Oh well, sometimes naming stuff can just be really hard, you know. Number 17. Cigarilla. Despite the way that people have been slinging around the phrase eighth wonder of the world in relation to anything that they think is kind of cool, there is apparently a place that has that official title. I mean, who knew? The frescoes at Sigiriya in Sri Lanka are, allegedly, going around under that very title. These pre-Christian frescoes are part of the ancient rock-built fortress and ruins of the palace at Lion's Rock. The whole place is found within a massive landscape of gardens and reservoirs, and it is quite nice, I suppose. But is it really up there with the other seven wonders of the world? Those would be the Great Pyramid of Giza, the Colossus of Rhodes, the Lighthouse at Alexandria, the Mausoleum, the Temple of Artemis, and the Statue of Zeus at Olympia, along with the Hanging Gardens of Babylon. Well, this Lion's Rock Palace is old, and it is made out of stone, so yeah, it probably does have the same arbitrary ancient stuff going for it. But what do you think? Let's have a chat about it down in the comments section below. Number 16. Congo's Hidden Carbon Bomb. Now, there are parts of Congo that are so remote that there are not even any maps of the area. The GPS, that's not going to help either. These parts are simply marked with a white space and a note that there is not enough data. It's deep within these dense jungles that there have been some recent discoveries that have unnerved environmentalists and no doubt excited the big bad fossil fuel companies with the promise of more filthy lucre. There is, apparently, a huge store of natural gas under the Congo rainforest, and a massive peatland all untouched, all still protecting the environment by remains intact. According to Greenpeace, approximately 58% of this heretofore unproved land has now been opened up to prospectors, and those greedy oil and gas companies are drooling all the way to the bank. What happens next could catapult the world into deeper and more rapid climate change. Well, fingers crossed then, I guess. Number 15. The Stone Spheres of Costa Rica. Back in the 1930s and the 40s, a scientific study would be conducted in which stone spheres that were found in Costa Rica were examined. But what's so unusual about that? Well, apparently these rocks, which are all found all across the country, and there are hundreds of them, are also completely round. Measurements have determined that they are actually, in many instances, totally spherical, and they're considered to be close to being perfect spheres, and scientists believe that they are in fact handmade. The studies conclude that these stone spheres were carved by the ancient people who were indigenous to a valley in Costa Rica. But just how they did this, and so very perfectly as well, is the thing that stumps scientists today. These spheres were predominantly carved from granodiorite, which is a very hard rock that shares many characteristics with granite. It's believed that the ancient people would choose rocks that were very round to begin with, and then, using tools that were essentially just smaller rocks of the same material, they carefully shaped them, perhaps also using heating and rapid cooling techniques. However, despite the scientists' ability to pin down a few possible techniques, the accuracy of the skill is still a tiny bit baffling. Number 14. Zombie Fungus. In the Amazon rainforest, there are many weird and wonderful things. There are also some truly creepy and gross things that we probably wish we didn't know about. But today, we're really leaning into the more disgusting side of life, so here you are. This is a type of fungus that makes insects into zombies. What that basically means is that this parasitic fungus attaches to the insect host by infecting the foraging creature through spores, and then it works to penetrate the insect's exoskeleton until it slowly controls its entire body. It sounds extremely sinister, and like the beginning of a horror movie, In the end, though, the fungus grows, and it compels the insect to move away from its own environment and into a more humid climate in order to favor the growth of the fungus. At this point, the insect is helpless to resist and will eventually wind up on a leaf. Interestingly, about 10 inches off the ground and with a northern-facing vantage point. Then the insect will be trapped until it dies, and it will die slowly as the fungus feeds on the insect's insides. After the insect dies, the fungus finally sends out a new fruiting body out of the base of the shriveled, dead insect's head, and that will send out new spores to infect new victims and start the cycle all over again. It's absolutely brutal. Number 13. The White City of the Monkey God. The remote Honduran rainforest has been under examination for almost a decade by a group of very determined archaeologists who believe that this may be the site of the lost city of legend known as the White City. This place is believed to have been dedicated to the monkey god of a pre-Columbian era. It is thought to be buried deep in the dense jungle, somewhere within the 1,350 square miles of the La Mosquito region of Honduras. One explorer and a team of researchers are accompanied by a security force of Special Forces soldiers and survival specialists as they attempt to discover more about the fabled city and explore the site.
We hit pay dirt, guys. Wow, this is awesome.
The studies that they have done would suggest that there may be palaces, ceremonial buildings, and as many as 60,000 homes that are all buried down beneath the jungle. The plot does thicken. Number 12. The Lost City of Giants. Back in 2012, a group of explorers discovered a place in the Amazonian jungle of Ecuador in which they believe that they had possibly stumbled across the remains of a long-lost ancient civilization of giants. Right then. Now I know, you've all heard and read and seen conclusive evidence that there were definitely giants walking the earth in history. I mean, whatever, go ahead and lambast the heck out of me, but it looks like a whole big load of cobblers to me. At this particular site, there were a bunch of stone structures. One of these was an extremely large sort of pyramid. Not, frankly, conclusive evidence of giants. I mean, people make massive stuff all the time, especially enormous pyramids. There are also loads and loads of artifacts that are scattered all over the area, and the usual stuff that you would expect to find in an abandoned place that had once been inhabited. You know, various pottery and stone items, and some of them were even extra large, but not all of them though. So, to conclude that these were a civilization of giants just seems a tiny bit presumptuous. They've allegedly found bones of an abnormally large size in some caves in the vague area, but there are also plenty of regular-sized bones and pots and dwellings and so on. So, you know. Number 11. Lord Hanuman's Giant Footprints. Hanuman is a Hindu god and is venerated for being a companion of the major Hindu deity Rama. So, Hanuman is a big deal amongst the believers in the Hindu religion. That also means that any site that's associated with this god is going to be considered important and super sacred. This is the phenomena of Lord Hanuman's giant footprints. These are sites all throughout Asia, which are believed to be the location of the actual giant footprints of the god Hanuman.
Which is amazing. If you take a look at this.
These are indentations in the solid rock of the Earth's surface, which are said to be places where he leapt from one country to another. These are located in Thailand, in Andhra Pradesh in India, in Sri Lanka, and in Malaysia. Now, I don't know how you feel about such things, but these footprints seem to draw rather a lot of tourist activity, and therefore the money that they bring with them. In fact, these are places of pilgrimage. Visitors will not only come there, but they also throw money into the footprints for luck. Not saying anything at all, but, well, you know. Number 10. The Sentinelese People. The Sentinelese are of the most isolated people on the planet. They actively reject any contact with the outside world, and they may have inhabited their island as a people for 55,000 years now. Complete isolation on a small island in the Indian Ocean means that the Sentinelese are violently protective of their territory and have murdered anyone that has poked their nose into their business. It does sound harsh, but with their neighboring islands' populations destroyed by disease that was imported from other places, any germ or virus that they might catch from an outsider would probably wipe them out. Obviously, it's tricky to understand anything much about a tribe that you can't really get near without receiving an arrow in the chest. And so, all that's known has been observed by a few nosy parkers on boats that were carefully moored further out than the arrows could reach off the coast of the island. In 1880, a British expedition would land on the island and discover the villages and houses abandoned. Presumably, the tribe had seen the invading force and then hidden themselves. The expeditioners did come across an old couple and some children, and in the hideous wisdom of the colonial attitude, they then kidnapped the people from the island for scientific reasons. The Sentinelese quickly became sick with disease, and the older people all perished. The children were returned to the island, but how many were then infected with deadly diseases is obviously unknown. It's no wonder that the outsider is met with hostility by the Sentinelese. Various attempts at communication have been made throughout the 1970s and 80s, with gifts being left on the beaches, but most were rejected and then buried by the tribe. More recently, it's finally been accepted that this is probably the safest for the Sentinelese tribe if they're just left in peace. I guess the nosy parkers have finally gotten the message. Number 9. Humpback whale in the jungle. A dead 10-ton humpback whale would be found about 15 meters away from the shore of a beach. So you know that it wasn't as if it had sort of flown into the rainforest and then landed there dead. But anyways, according to scientists who know about such things, this is still a weird place for a whale to be, especially at that particular time of year. The plot does thicken.
Nós encontramos uma baleia imensa.
The massive mammal carcass was discovered in some undergrowth at the mouth of the Amazon River, but it's believed that it most probably died while way out at sea and then was gradually washed up in this spot by the tides. It's not exactly rocket science, but then again, pretty much anything that happens anywhere can end up on the internet famed as a news story now, can't it? So, as far as anyone can say, this is a strange place for a whale to be, but a dead whale can probably rock up wherever the waters take it. And that is that, really. Mystery solved. Number 8. The Mystery of Billy Ape. In the mid-1990s, a photographer and conservationist named Carl Amon came across a weird footnote in an old manuscript, and it got him all kinds of excited. Well, it does take all sorts, doesn't it? Anyways, what Amon discovered would lead him to look at a bunch of unusual skulls that had been disregarded up until that point. The skulls were sat gathering dust in a museum in Belgium, but Amon discovered that they had originally come from a remote area of northern Congo. The skulls were a real head-scratcher, and they had been classified as gorilla skulls, but were from an area that had no gorillas. Amon then decided that this was a mystery that he needed to solve. So, he went off to Congo, and it was there that he had heard tales of giant apes that were unlike any others. They were said to howl at the moon, to be immune to poisonous darts, and to be so strong that they could kill lions. And that's when Amon became hooked. He would spend the next decade rummaging around in the Billy Forest in remote northern Congo, looking for these mysterious apes. And what he found are believed to be traces of these apes, but no conclusive evidence. It was not an easy task. He actually contracted malaria 25 times, and this would usually be enough to put off most people, but he just kept on searching for those elusive apes. And then finally, after a lifetime of searching, DNA evidence was tested, and it concluded that the apes that he was searching for were none other than, drumroll please, chimpanzees. That's right, 10 years and multiple malaria infections, only to discover that there was no new secret ape at all. Sucks to be him, but, you know, full marks for effort nonetheless. Number 7. Silkhenge. This next one is still a mystery that, even though it's believed that spiders build these unusual structures, nobody has yet determined exactly what sort of spiders do it. These structures are known as Silkhenge creations on the account of their shape. They have a central spire-shaped part around which there are several other parts that form a kind of fence. The central piece generally contains the spider's eggs. The circular shape of these structures has given them the name, which is obviously duh, after Stonehenge, the ancient and mysterious stone circle in the United Kingdom. These incredibly miniature Silkhenges were only discovered by scientists as recently as 2013, and nobody has yet managed to determine which species actually makes their egg protection in this matter. Now, there is footage, however, of the tiny baby spiders as they break out of the web protections, but nobody has yet established what species they belong. Do you have any ideas? Go ahead and have a bit of a ponder about it in the comments down below. Number 6. Man hid in jungle for 30 years. When some people say they're going to do something, they might really mean it, and they're not going to give up ever. This is the strange tale of a man named Hiro Onoda. He was a lieutenant in the Japanese army during the Second World War. In December of 1944, as that conflict was finally coming to an end, Onoda was stationed on the extremely small island of Lubang in the Philippines. Within just a few short weeks, the rest of the Japanese forces on the island met in battle with the United States Army, and they were pushed out into the jungle there. Somehow, however, Onoda was not caught up in this fight, and he remained hidden in position to defend the island. In fact, he remained hidden for another 30 years. He was declared officially dead by the Japanese government in 1959, but in actuality, he was still standing by, convinced that the war had never ended, and that he was still performing the secret mission that he had been assigned on in the first place. It is crazy, but it's also true. Number 5. The Lost City of El Mirador. The lost Mayan city of El Mirador had once been the thriving capital of that entire civilization. But unlike other ancient monuments to the great pre-Hispanic era peoples of South America, this one is not exactly what one would call a tourist hotspot. In fact, it is pretty tricky to find at all, let alone take a tour around. Located deep in the subtropical rainforest in northern Guatemala, the site of El Mirador is at the end of a treacherous trek through thick forests in which an explorer might drown in mud or be bitten to death by mosquitoes, or even, if especially unlucky, become lunch for an opportunistic jaguar. So, it's not exactly a place that any old Tom, Dick, and Harry can just pop in and visit. It's possible to reach the place by helicopter, but even then, the entire adventure is fraught with hazards. All around, there are other remarkable Mayan ruins and many of super popular tourist destinations, but this one is still hard to reach and somewhat hidden. The real mystery lies within the fact this peculiar place had once been home to a great civilization. At least 200,000 people had lived in this one place, possibly as many as a million, and there's almost no evidence that it was ever the case. It was abandoned over 2,000 years ago and then reabsorbed by the rainforest. Number 4. Vietnamese Tarzan. Back in the dark days of Vietnam, a boy named Ho Van Lang and his father, Ho Van Than, fled into the depths of the Vietnamese jungle to escape the bombings. That was in 1972, and that's also where they remained until 2013, when they were forced to enter a nearby village to seek medical care for the older man who was becoming very ill. Apparently, they didn't even know that the war had long since ended. After this, the elderly man died in 2017, and his son, Ho Van Lang, left his jungle life and then went to live within the modern world. He had an older brother who had not gone to live in the jungle, so he went on to live with him after the death of their father. The interest in this story grew after an explorer decided to take him back to the jungle to find out exactly how he had been living. Sadly, though, in September of 2021, Ho Van Lang died of cancer at the age of 50. Many have blamed the change of lifestyle as he moved to live within the contemporary world and was introduced to foods which he had never eaten before that were full of chemicals as well as drinking alcohol. Perhaps modern life really is quite rubbish. Number 3. Cambodia's Hidden Jungle Temple. This area in Cambodia is part of the Angkor Temple complex that draws about a bazillion visitors every year. This one is a quieter and less impressive sort of experience, but still a place that's worth a look, and apparently is simply oozing mystery. And who doesn't enjoy a good mystery alongside your ancient, rumbling architecture? This temple, although clearly there, is not mentioned in any of the texts that are related to the empire that once existed in the area. This means that nobody knows when it was built, by whom, or indeed what the heck it was even for. Where some of the other structures nearby are still in relatively good shape, this one is basically knackered, all of its sculptures are gone and not much remains, except a crumbling ruin being reclaimed by a rainforest and a big old question mark over everything about it. Anyways, if you enjoy literal piles of bricks with mysterious undertones, then this is the dream destination for you. If, however, you require answers and actual structures, well, then perhaps go look at the more famous ones that are nearby instead. Number 2. Mysterious rings. The more that we view our world from the skies, you know, with stuff like drone cameras and Google Earth and such, the more oddities and strange phenomena we seem to discover. That new and elevated perspective is revealing ancient secrets that we had otherwise lived alongside of for a millennia without ever much wondering about. But now, we're greedy to know all of the Earth's secrets, like this weird bunch of old circles in the rainforest, for example. These are a series of round fish ditches that are positioned all throughout the Amazon rainforest in Bolivia and Brazil. Research into the purpose and the origin of these things has apparently revealed that they are possibly older than the rainforest that exists there today. They are seemingly human-made, although for what purpose exactly remains somewhat mysterious. Now, I don't know. When there's a mysterious circle, isn't it always really to do with aliens? Shouldn't we just accept that aliens love circles and be done with it all? Well, apparently, scientists are eager to find a proper answer and have suggested that these ditches were used for something much more boring than landing your spaceship. They reckon that they were likely as not used for either defense or drainage, or perhaps even religious ceremonial stuff. Wow, what a very small amount of choices, right? Drainage is kind of dull, but then again, sometimes weird discoveries turn out to have boring functional purposes. It can't always be mysticism and space travel, you know? Number 1. Sculpture Garden in Mexico. Las Posas is a weird and wonderful collection of sculptures randomly positioned in the midst of a Mexican jungle. In the late 1940s, an eccentric chap by the name of Edward James had decided to make this place in Mexico his home, and he filled it full of strange sculptures unlike anything you'll see anywhere else. Inspired by surrealism, the writer made a space that is a mess of dreams and subconscious oddities that is unsettling and fascinating in equal measure. There are giant flowers, gothic arches, and highly stylized gates and pavilions, and there are also unsettling spiral staircases with no obvious purpose and an overall feeling of dreamlike weirdness. This guy, as it turns out, would be described by none other than Salvador Dali as crazier than all the surrealists put together. And that really says it all, doesn't it? Well, that's all from the depths of the jungle for today. Which of these mysterious discoveries has you scratching your head in puzzlement? And do you have an answer for any of these mysteries? As always, let me know all of your splendid thoughts in the comments section down below. Also, be sure to check out the other cool stuff that's showing up on the screen, and I'll see you next time. I love you.